first female pelvic floor conference. وده بيمثل أول نشاط علمي لقسم الأمراض الحوض عند السيدات الموجود هنا في مستشفى الإسكندرية للكلى والمسالك الدورية Female Pelvic Floor Center. الحقيقة فكرة إنشاء الفيميل بيلفيك فلور سنتر دي بدأت معايا من حوالي 10 سنين لما كنت في USA وكنت بشتغل في كليفلاند كلينك وشفت هناك قد إيه دكاترة اليورولوجي والفيميل يورولوجي ودكاترة اليوروجينيكولوجي والكولوريكتال سيرجن والفيزيوثيرابيست ومعاهم اليوروديناميك سنتر وكمان الراديولوجيست بيتعاونوا مع بعض وبيقدموا خدمة ممتازة للفيميلز اللي بيشتكوا من مشاكل في البيلفيك فلور. فطبعا كان الحلم بيراودني وكنت اتمنى اقول ايه ليه ما نلاقيش في مصر سنتر زي ده، واحنا عندنا الحمد لله الكفاءات وكلنا سافرنا وشفنا وتعلمنا كويس جدا في سواء في امريكا او في اوروبا. لكن الحمد لله ربنا وفقنا وانشانا اول قسم للفيميل يورولوجي والبيلفيك فلور ديس اوردرز في مستشفى الاسكندريه للكلى والمسالك الدوريه، يكاد يكون المركز الاول من نوعه في مصر ويمكن في الشرق الاوسط. النهارده عندنا تو سيشنز هيشتغلوا على الهوت توبكس في كل ما يخص البيلفيك فلور ديسفانكشن، سواء كان من اليورينري ديسفانكشن، فيكال ديسوردرز، سيكشوال ديسفانكشن او بيلفيك اورجان برولابس، وي هاو تو مانج اند وات از اب تو ديت ميجرز تو تريت ذيس ديسوردرز. هنبدأ دلوقتي ويلكم توك من أستاذ دكتور سعد محمد سعد سي او اوف اي او اتش، وبعدين نبدأ على طول أول ساينتفك سيشن. أستاذ سعد.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، أرحب بيكم جميعا وبشكركم على الحضور في الجو ده، احنا نفسنا ما كناش عايزين نيجي يعني عشان الجو الوحيد. بعد قام الصبح على رعد وبتاع، فكتر خيرك يعني، احنا قلنا حتى في الجو ده يعني ممكن ما حدش يجي خالص، كتر الف خيرك يعني انكم جيتوا، ودي فرصه انكم تشوفوا هذا الكونستراكشن المبنى ده واللي بيحصل فيه وبتاع، فرصه جديده. كمان يعني لا يفوتني ان انا ارحب اخواتي الدكتور علي الصبري، الدكتور احمد، الدكتور جابر، اللي قبلوا ان هم يتجشموا الحضور في هذا الجو، وربنا يوفق الجميع ان شاء الله.
اول برزنتيشن ان شاء الله هقولها عن فيميل ستريس يوريك كونتنس ريسنت ابورتس. Definition of female stress urinary incontinence. It is involuntary loss of urine with increased intra-abdominal pressure in the absence of detrusor contraction. And we have two common types of stress incontinence. Type 1 and 2 is caused by urethral hypermobility, where the urethra is immobile with increased intra-abdominal pressure due to lack of pelvic organ, pelvic muscle support. And the other type is IVCD or intrinsic sphincteric deficiency, which is type 3 stress incontinence. How to evaluate patients with stress incontinence? We usually start by doing what's called a stress test. We ask the patient to cough and strain during examination, and we assess the urethral hypermobility by what's called Q-tip test to see the degree of mobility of the urethra, to see whether there is mobility, hypermobility or not. And we don't forget to assess the associated pelvic organ prolapse, either anterior, posterior, or apical prolapse, and also to see the integrity of the pelvic floor muscle, and most important here is the perineal body. It is very important, if the patient has associated prolapse, to search for occult incontinence. How to do that? By vaginal back test, and here we reduce the prolapse and ask the patient to cough and see whether there is incontinence or not. And this gives us a clue to how to manage, whether to associate anti-incontinence surgery with prolapse surgery or not. I want to ask for urodynamics for patients with stress incontinence. If the patient has recurrent stress after anti-stress surgery, or she is coming with mixed incontinence, if she had obstruction or high postural and residual urine, and also if there is associated incontinence with prolapse. The treatment of female stress incontinence passed through many stages. We may ask for, we start with conservative treatment for patients who are unavailable for surgery, or patients with mild cases, like the vaginal wounds. Also, sometimes we prescribe medications like chloroquine, which is an STS high, in power to extend the sphincter. Also, in large cases, and its efficacy actually is low and has some side effects. The surgical procedures started from the traditional care and then reached now the most advanced and most recent minimally invasive surgery. In the old era, they started by vaginal penis suspension, the Pereira and the STEMI, and the RAS procedure, where the suspension of the urethra is carried out by the help of some threads that pass with the needle to the retropubic area. Then the Bersh corpus suspension came to the era, and still now it is used, Bersh corpus suspension, where the para-urethral tissue are attached by suture to the victimial line in the back of the pubic bone, giving very good support to the urethra and the bladder neck. And the gold standard treatment for severe stress incontinence is what's called pubovaginal sling, where we suspend the proximal urethra and the bladder neck with the use of graft. This graft may be a natural graft, like the rectus cheese graft, cadaveric fasciolata, or porcine dermis, or maybe synthetic graft. And this is very effective in cases of severe stress incontinence due to ICE. In Alexandria, and we have here our professor, Dr. Abdelaziz Sabrifai, who developed the first vaginal flap used for treatment of stress urinary incontinence, tension-free vaginal flap, where a rectangular flap is used from the anterior vaginal wall and suspended by the use of four threads and passing up to the anterior abdominal wall by the help of needles. And this is used natural tissue to support the urethra. The modification of this is to augment the flap with the diagonal sutures of the duodenum threads and roll it, what's called roll fortified vaginal flap, also developed at Alexandria University. What about the new techniques for stress urinary incontinence? Actually, now the treatment is moving towards the minimally invasive surgery. We have the vaginal tapes, like the tension-free vaginal tape, or TVT. We have the transobturator tape, or the TOT. And then main slings, the small size sling, and also followed by adjustable slings that allows you to adjust the pressure after the operation, either to increase it or to decrease it. We have the injectables, and lastly, we have the tissue engineering. What is the idea of tension-free vaginal tape? We use the synthetic tape and support the mid-urethra, where the external sphincter is present, to back of the anterior abdominal wall, in front of the rectus sheath. It is done under spinal anesthesia. Usually, we start by infiltration of the anterior vaginal wall with saline to help for dissection, and then we dissect by sharp and scissor towards the pubic area, and then the needle should pass in both sides of the urethra, and here you have to put a urethral catheter to make sure that the bladder is empty and to avoid any injury of the bladder. And lastly, when you stabilize the tape, you have to put an instrument between the urethra and the tape to avoid any tension over the urethra and avoid any post-operative erosion. And we cut the tape at the end of the procedure, flush with the skin on the anterior abdomen. The transobturator tape is a new one for tapes developed after the PVT. And the idea here is to pass the tape in the obturator foramen, not behind the pubic. Many types of tapes are developed and available now in the market. And here we start also by dissection in the anterior vaginal wall by anterior incision. and move the needle. You see here the helical needle that allow you to pass the tip behind the pubic arch toward the vagina. We have two types, either outside in or inside in, where the passage of the pass from the vagina toward the obturator for it. And this picture shows the tip pulled out by the needle. And as we did in the TVT, we have to put an instrument between the tip and the urethra to avoid any tension. Here is a question. Would you use the TVT or TOT to stress incontinence? And TOT are more or less similar, about 90 to 92%. But the post-operative complications are more with TVT, meaning that the obstructive voiding and bladder perforation are higher than TVT. That's why it is most commonly used now to treat female with stress urinary incontinence. What about mini stings? Small size stings, avoid the use of needles at all. No passage of needle to get TVT secure, and the mini arc sting. It is applied also through the anterior vaginal wall through a small incision. And a hook by a small hook, both sides of the uterus. Is it effective like the TVT and the International Urogynecological Association meeting 2015 showed that after 2 years follow-up, the success rate with TVT is 96%, whereas with the mini stent is only 60%. Overbuilding, because this stent actually can be applied by local in our patient. What about the adjustable tips? Actually, this is a very nice type of tips that allow you to adjust the tension of the tip after the operation, meaning that if the patient after the operation develops recurrent or persistent incontinence, you can apply pulling. This cell or rods can be cut after the operation to be moved onward or out. The other modality is the injectables that also can control in stress incontinence. The idea here is that you inject the material around the area of the sphincter. Some may cause an injection by the endoscopy. So before the injection, the urethra is wide. After the injection, the urethra is now narrow. That can prevent urine leakage. Many types of the and the zeotix, and balconine, and the durosphere. The problem here is some of these injectables develop granuloma after the operation. Some of them may migrate away from the urethra, losing the effect of compression. And that's why most of these injectables are and tissues from the patient can be taken and put in cell culture and to give injection again with the autologous muscle inside the patient, giving the new sphincteric area. It is a dream, but still experimental, and we are waiting for new efforts to see what are the results of tissue engineering in the area of implant. This is about the end of my presentation. The recommendations developed by European Association of Urology in 2016. What are the most commonly used procedures to treat stress incontinence? As you see here in the box, the three procedures that take level A or grade A recommendation are Birch corpus suspension, bladder nips then using autologous fascia, and TVT and TOT to treat stress incontinence. The other old procedures are no longer used. The bulking agent and the laparoscopic bridge have level or grade B recommendation. Thank you. Any questions?
Patient with simple, straightforward, clear stress urinary incontinence or not?
Very good question. If you have a patient with genuine stress incontinence, straightforward case, not mixed incontinence, no neurogenic abnormality, no associated prolapse, not a recurrent case, you can go ahead.
You don't have to do it. you don't have to do your dynamic, and you can go ahead and apply the tape for this patient and the whole implant. Father, please.
Thank you very much. In 2020, what's the list of open percussion procedure while we have all these alternatives?
Yes.
Of course, Mersh can be done by
laparoscopy
or open. Yeah. But what is the exact list for this?
Actually, we don't have a base now for this, except you are doing laparotomy for this patient, like you are doing repair of prolapse, abdominal prolapse. You can add base for this patient to control the incontinence. But as long as the tips are effective and they are minimally invasive, most of us as urologists, urogynecologists, offer TOT or TBT for the patient.
How often you face complication with the TOT or the TBT, like erosions and so on?
Yeah.
How often?
Thank you for this question. Actually, with the TBT, we usually encounter the obstruction after the operation, and the patient comes to suffer from hesitancy, weak stream. Some of them come to suffer from retention. With the TOT, actually, the complication rate is very, very low. We never, even the erosion, in my practice, I didn't see this.
About the real things,
yes.
I've seen this more than 15 years ago, and I think it doesn't work anymore.
Yes, you are right, because they are not a good support for the urethra. To hammock the urethra, either towards the pubic area in the TBT or towards the obturator foramen like the TBT. The main stems are not
used anymore.
No, we here in Alexandria, we don't use it. Okay, thank you.